गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक वंस अगेन टू योर मैथ्स ऑनलाइन क्लास ऑफ क्लास टू. यस्टरडे वी हैड स्टार्टेड द सेकेंड चैप्टर, दैट इज नंबर्स. आई होप यू हैव डन द होमवर्क दैट वॉज गिवन टू यू इन द प्रीवियस क्लास. नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक. सो द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक दैट इज इन दिस चैप्टर, इट इज असेंडिंग ऑर्डर एंड descending order. Okay, now first, what is the meaning of ascending order? Okay, ascending means small to big. Okay, and descending means big to small. Okay, kindly remember this. Many students, they get confused in the names ascending and descending. Ascending means small to big, descending means big to small. So order means to arrange the numbers. Okay, so over here we will arrange the numbers from small to big. Okay, and in descending from big to small. For example, if I write some numbers here, suppose 652, 481, 710, 302. Now what are we going to do here? As I told you, we are going to arrange these numbers once again in ascending order. Ascending means from small to big. Now whichever number is the smallest, that comes first. Okay, then the next number which is bigger than that, that will come next, then the other bigger, then the biggest. Okay, now when we look at numbers, okay, we always look them in which place? In the hundreds place. Okay, now we have 6 4 7 3. We have these numbers in the hundreds place, 6 4 7 3. Now by looking at these numbers, you find out which is the smallest. When you look at these numbers, which is the smallest here? Yes, 3. That means this number. So the first number will be 302. Put a comma after that. Now this number is already done. Okay, then there are three numbers remaining. Now out of 6 4 and 7, which number is small? Yes, it is 4. That means this number, 481. Again put a comma, this number is done. Then now we have 6 and 7 remaining. Now which is small, 6 or 7? Yes, 6 is small. That means this number, 652. Again put a comma, and the remaining last number is 710. Okay, now when you look at these numbers, you'll see that it is arranged in order of small to big. We have 302, the smallest, then 481, then 652, and then 710. So this is how we do ascending order. That means arranging the numbers from the smallest to biggest, or from small to big. I hope you have understood this part. Okay, then we move to the next, that is descending order. Now as you can see, descending is just the opposite. Descending means big to small. The number that is big, or the biggest number, will come first going to the smallest. Okay, once again, for example, I am giving some numbers here. Okay, I have given some numbers like 726, 841, 511, and 940. Now once again, I told you earlier, when you arrange numbers from bigger to smaller or smaller to bigger, what we do? We look the numbers that are in the or that is in the hundreds place, the first number. Okay, now we have 7, 8, 5, 9. Now as you can see, we have to arrange it from big to small. Okay, so which is the biggest number here out of 7, 8, 5, and 9? It is 9, this number here. Okay, so 940 comes first. Okay, this is done. Then we have three more numbers remaining, 7, 8, and 5. Now which is the biggest here? It is 8. That means this number, 841, it comes next. This is also done. Then we have two more numbers remaining, 7 and 5. Now which is bigger, 7 or 5? It is 7. That means this number, 726, 726. And the last number remaining is 511, that is 511. So now when you look at these numbers, you can see that they are arranged in order from big to small. See, the first one is 940, then 841, then we have 726, and then we have 511. Okay, so I hope you have understood ascending order and descending order. Once again, to make it clear, ascending order means small to big or smaller to bigger, and descending order means big to small or bigger to smaller. You have to arrange the given numbers in this way. Okay, what is asked, whether it is ascending or descending. Okay, so based on this, you have exercises given here on page number 20. Okay, so I will be doing the first numbers with you, and the remaining numbers you will do it yourself in your maths book. Kindly don't do it again in your maths copy, okay? In your maths book you have to do it. Now this exercise is on page number 20, exercise A. Okay, it is asked here, write in ascending order. Okay, the first question is, or the first number is 125, 236, 698, and then we have 447. Now the numbers are given like this, you have to arrange them in order from smaller to bigger. Okay, so which is the smallest number here? That is, I told you to look the numbers in the hundreds place. So we have 1, 2, 6, and 4. The smallest number is this one. So 125 comes first, then the next number 2, 6, and 4. Which is the smallest? 2. So we write this 236. Then we have two more numbers remaining, 6 and 4. So which is smaller, 6 or 4? It is 4. That means this number, 447, and in the last we have 698. Okay, I have done the first one with you. You have number 2, 3, and 4 after that, which you have to do it yourself. Okay, then we move to exercise B. On the same page, we have exercise B, that is arrange the numbers in descending order. Okay, now the first question over there is 123, 448, then we have 63 and 817. Okay, so you have to arrange them in descending order. As I told you, descending means bigger to smaller or big to small. Now once again you take a look at the first number, okay, that is in the hundreds place. Now if you pay attention, you'll see that we have here 123, 448, 817, but the third number here is only 63. There is no number in the hundreds place. That is understood very easily that this number is the smallest because it has only two digits. So automatically this number will be right in the last. Okay, Now leave them, the remaining three numbers that is left now, 1, 4 and 8. Now, which is the greatest year or the biggest? Yes, it is 8, this number here, 817. This is the biggest, okay? After that, which number is left now? 1 and 4. Out of these two, which number is bigger, 1 or 4? It is 4, this one, 448. Then we have this, 123. And as I told you, 63 will come right in the last because it has only two digits. So automatically it becomes the smallest number. So it will be placed right at the last. Okay? So I have done the first number with you. Number 2, 3 and 4. It is your homework. You will do it yourself. Okay? Now, on the same page, we have exercise C and exercise D. Now, in exercise C and D, what we have to do is, in exercise C, circle the greatest number, and in exercise D, circle the smallest number. Now, take for example, if I give you some numbers here, suppose some numbers are here, 621, 842 and 738. Now what you have to do is circle the greatest number. Greatest means the biggest, okay? Now when you look at these numbers, the first number in the hundreds place, we have 6, 8 and 7. Now which number is bigger or greatest or biggest? It is, compared to these three, it is 8. So what you have to do, you have to circle this number. Is it clear? It is very simple. You see the first number that is in the hundreds place, the biggest number, circle that whole thing. Okay? And the next exercise is, okay, exercise, this was exercise C. Okay? You have to circle the greatest number. Now, next we have exercise D. Over there you have to do is, you have to circle the smallest number, the opposite. Okay, once again, suppose I'll give some numbers here, 248, 160 and 342, for example. Okay, now once again you'll take a look at the numbers that is in the hundreds place. We have 2, we have 1 and we have 3. Okay, so out of these three numbers, which is the smallest? Is it 2, 1 or 3? Yes, it is 1. So this number here, 160, this becomes the smallest number. So you have to circle that. Okay? So on page number 20, exercise C and D, you'll do it yourself. In exercise D, C, you have to circle the greatest number. And in exercise D, you have to circle the smallest number. Okay, so now we will move to the next topic in this chapter. That topic is place value. And face value. Now, what is place value? And what is face value of a given number? For example, if I write some numbers here, suppose if I write 842. Now, this number here, 842, okay? 2 is in 1's place, 4 is in 10's place, and 8 is in 100's place, okay? Now, what is the meaning of place value? Place value, as you can see the word place. Place means the position. The position where the number is. Now the first number here is 2. Then we have in 10's place 4. And we have in 8, in 100's place 8. Okay? Now, suppose if I take this number, for example, 4. Now, what is the place value of 4? Place value means which place is it? Okay, and what is the position of 4? Now, as you can see, 4 is in the tens place. Okay, so its value is 40. So the place value of 4 is 40. Why did I write 40? Because it is in the tens place. So in tens place we have to add a 0, so it becomes 40. And in the same way, what is the face value of the number 4? The face value of a number will always be the number itself. So the face value of 4 is 4 itself. Okay? In the same way, let us practice some more numbers. If I give you, say for example, 262. Okay? Once again, when you look at these numbers, okay, 2, 6, 2. Now say for example, I take 2. The 2 that is in the hundreds place. Okay? Now, what is the place value of 2?